Now hello class, today we are going to write some different patterns. Like in our previous programs or previous pattern, what we do, we just write a program and print any type of specific fixed patterns. Like where 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3 is there. We all know what type of pattern is pattern we need to print. So now, but in this program, we are going to write a pattern coding, or we are going to write a pattern program where we don't know the number of terms. If I am talking about number of terms, it means we are going to discuss about number of rows. Like in a program like 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we see 4 rows are there, 5 rows are there. Clear? In all program there are 5 rows are there. So in this program we don't know how many rows. So rows are defined as a number of terms. So we don't know about number of terms. We need to take it as an input from user. And also we are going to write a program where in a single program we print triangle as well as triangle means triangle type pattern as well as inverted triangle. Like if I'm talking about triangle and inverted triangle, then it is just like this way. Like if I'm talking about triangle, then this one is our triangle, and if I'm talking about inverted triangle, then this one is our inverted triangle. So in this program we are going to write a code pattern program where we print triangle as well as inverted triangle. Now what is triangle? Then it is just like 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 4, 4, 4. And inverted triangle, then it is just like 4, 4, 4, 4, 3, 3, 3, 2, 2, and then 1. This type of program. Clear? I hope you all know what is triangle and what is inverted triangle. So now see, write a program to generate a triangle. It means this one. Or an inverted triangle. So if inverted triangle, then this thing. Till n terms. We don't know number of terms. Like here 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Maybe it is 5 number of terms. Like this way. Or maybe it is 6 number of terms. Like this way. Or maybe it is 3 number of terms in this way. Same thing happens here. Maybe it is 5 number of terms, then this one is like this way. 5 times 5 is also there. It is 4 number of 3 number of terms, then it is just like this way. So we don't know about number of terms. It is totally depend on user what number of terms they want. If they want 2, 3, 5, 7, whatever they want, it print in that way. Clear class? So now see, once again, I am going to read the question. Write a program to generate a triangle or an inverted triangle till n number of terms. Triangle and inverted triangle, and n number of terms means number of rows, n rows are there. Based upon user's choice of a triangle. Now we are going to write a program where we print two triangles, inverted as well as normal triangle. So what type of triangle gives us output? It totally depends on user. If user want to print triangle, then it print triangle. If user want to print inverted triangle, then it print inverted triangle. So see, we are going to write one example. Two examples are there. And first of all, we understand example. And then we are going to write a program. Like this one is example 1. So input. So in input, already it is displayed 1 for triangle. Clear? There is a 1 for triangle, and here is also one more message, like I'm in this way. 1 for triangle and 2 for inverted triangle. So suppose user enter their choice 1. It means user want to print triangle. After 1, again ask, enter the number of terms, means how many number of terms you want, like how many number of rows you want. So suppose user write 6, then automatically the sample output is, or the output is in this way, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 4, 4, 4, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 6, 6, 6, 6. 6, 6. Now what we see? Enter the number of terms. If there is a 6, then it print 6 rows. Suppose this is 4 User want to print four terms, so automatically this is in this way. Same thing happens here. One for triangle and two for inverted triangle. It print message like this way. Now enter your choice. Suppose user print or write two. So now again ask enter the number of terms. Suppose here user input 6. Now sample output is in this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. And then 2 and then 1. So our output is this way. Suppose user write here 5. Then our output is in this way. If user write there 4, then it is in this way. So it's totally depend on user how many terms they want or how many rows they want, as well as what type of triangle they want. After the, giving their input like 1 and 4, whatever is there, we print this one or this one as an output. So open your copies and start writing the program which I am going to write. If you all want, then you can write this type of program itself, and otherwise I am going to write all program codes. Students, be careful. If you all have any doubt, then you can ask me. But if you all do not have any doubt, then write a program or write a program itself. Now, how we start our program? This one is a question. Write a program to generate a triangle or an inverted triangle till n terms based upon user's choice of a triangle to be displayed. Now we all know this is the menu driven programmer also. Switch case program. So we start from here. Import java dot asterisk and then this one. Now after this, public class, and suppose the name of our class is switch pattern. Clear? This is totally depend on us what type of class name we want. If I want, then I just write here switch pattern. If you want, then you can write something other. Now after this, public static void main string string args. Clear? And then after writing public static void main whatever is there, we need to write scanner in this one. Scanner in equals to new scanner system dot in. We all know why I am writing here. In our previous program we did not write these statements or this one, just because of we do not have need to take any input from user. But in this program we need to take choice of user as well as number of terms, so we need to take something as an input from user. Clear? So that's why, just because of taking input from user, we need to write this import java.util, because we need to import something, and just for importing we need to write this one, scanner in equals to new scanner system dot in. Now after this, we need to create variables. What type of variable we want? Like the first thing is choice, ch, just for storing like what type of triangle we want. If I want to print 1 as a triangle, so we need to write 1, 2, then we need to write 2. So see how we complete these things. There is a ch, and then n for number of terms, like number of rows, and then a and b for completing our inner and outer loop. Because we all know if we need to print pattern, so we need to run two loop, which is nested loop is also known. And there is a one outer loop, and another there is a nested inner loop. So just because of outer and inner loop, we need to take some two more variables, and then there is a semicolon. Now, after this means after creating the variables, we need to take input. System dot out dot print ln. One more thing is scanner input new scanner system dot in. Then there is a semicolon. System dot out dot print ln, and then enter your choice. Clear, and then again system. I'm directly writing here SOPLN. SOPLN, and then 1 for triangle and 2 for inverted triangle. You all have need to write triangle complete here. Clear? I'm just writing the symbol. So 1 for triangle, 2 for inverted triangle, and then whatever triangle user want, ch equals to in dot next int. If user want to print triangle, then user gives 1. If user want to print inverted triangle, then user we can say that press second button or 2 number of button. So whatever value user gives, like 1 or 2, it stores under a variable ch. Clear? If user want to print triangle, then ch equal to 1. If user want to print inverted triangle, then obviously user write press 2 and the value of ch is 2. Now after this, we need to write to switch case, like switch, 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 and there is a ch. Now after writing ch, there is a case 1. If user want to print triangle, then ch equals to 1, and it comes to the case case 1. Now in case 1, next thing is we need to take input as a number of terms. So we just write here SOPLN enter the number of terms. Clear? And whatever number of terms is there, it is n equal to in dot next int. Clear? Whatever number of terms are there, number of terms. Clear? Whatever number of terms are there means whatever number of rows are there, it stores under a variable n. Now after this, we need to run loop because of printing pattern. So we can write here SOPLN the triangle pattern. This one is a appropriate method for printing our triangle pattern. So the triangle pattern is, because in case one print triangle pattern, so just SOPLN pattern is there, and then what we write, it is n equal to n dot next is, then we are going to write for a equals to 1. Because if user want to print triangle, means if user want to print case 1 pattern, case 1 means 1 for triangle pattern, so the pattern is in this way. Like 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 4, 4, 4. Totally depend on user what type of pattern they want. If user want to print this pattern like triangle pattern,
So 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 4, 4. Maybe it is 5, 5, 5, 5 also. But we don't know number of terms stores under a variable n. So we just write here a equals to 1 and a is less than or equal to n. Clear? Be careful, students, because you all need to understand these things. N equal to in dot next in means number of rows 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe 5, maybe 6, maybe only 3 is there. So whatever number of rows, number of terms are there, it stores under a variable n. Clear? So a is less than or equal to n, and then a plus plus. Clear? Now after this, outer loop responsible for number of terms. So it starts from 1 and end with n number of terms. Clear? So outer loop completed their work. Now we are going to work on inner loop. So start from b equals to 1, and again b is less than or equal to a, because suppose it is 10, then outer loop run 10 number of times. So it's totally the inner loop value totally depend on user outer loop. So it is b plus plus, and then system dot out dot print a, and then we also want to print space, because this one is a space between the numbers. We want to print space, so just for because of space we just write a plus space and then semicolon. Now system dot out dot print ln. Clear? And then close. So this curly bracket is for this one and this curly bracket is for this one. Clear? Now after this, this one is our case 1 program. Now we are going to write case 2 program, because if user print 2 or user press 2 but second number button, then ch equals to 2, then automatically ch goes to case 2. So for printing case 2 is inverted triangle, I'm going to erase these things. You all have need to write. Clear? After writing, I'm going to erase it. So suppose user want to print case 2 pattern like inverted triangle. So what we do? We also need to erase these things. These all are things for case 1. Now we are going to print case 2. So for case 2, this one is case 2. So let's say I am going to write this pattern from here. Now case 2. Now what we do? Again we have need to take input as a number of terms. So SOP ln and then enter the number of terms. Clear? Enter the number of terms, and whatever term is there, it is in dot next int. Clear? Enter the number of terms. For inverted triangle, if I want, then I can also write here for inverted triangle, but there is a no need to write. So I'm just simple writing enter the number of terms and then n equal to in dot next int. This term is for inverted triangle. Now after this, SOP ln, the inverted triangle pattern. Now inverted triangle pattern is for, now how is our inverted triangle pattern? So see, inverted triangle pattern is in this way, like 4, 4, 4, 4, 3, 3, 3, 2, 2, 1. Clear? So if user gives input 6, then it starts from 6. If user write there 5, then it starts from 5. So now a is equals to, now our loop is start from number of terms whatever number of terms user gives. So A equals to N, and then suppose it is 6. So now A is equal to 6, then it start printing from 6. So our condition is always greater than, like A is greater than or equal to 1, and then A minus minus, it start from printing 6 and end with 1, and always it is decremented form or decremented operator is there. Now after this, for B equals to, now again outer loop is responsible for number of terms. It completed their work. Now we are going to write inner loop. Now inner loop is start from 1 and end with number of outer loop, which is A. So B is less than or equal to A. This one is there. Now B is less than or equal to A, and then B plus plus. And after this, system dot out dot one. For B equals to 1, B is less than or equal to A, and then B plus plus. Clear? And then SOP, and in SOP we are going to print A and then plus space. Clear? And then SOP LN is there, and case 2 program will completed. Clear? SOP A plus and then SOP LN is there. Now after this, when case 2 is completed, one more thing is left. In case 1, we just write our complete program in a correct manner. But there is a one mistake is there. When we complete the programming code or the concept, the coding system of case 1, then in last, we all ever need to write break, which we have not write in case 1. So always remember that thing. In case 1, when we are completing the case 1 program, from this one to this one, so in last we all of need to write break. Clear? So same thing happen here. When case 2 is there, then in last there is a break statement. We all know what is break statement. Because of break statement, our program will terminate. Suppose user write 2 or gives input of 2 second inverted triangle of triangle choice, then it comes directly to the case 2 and write the program and print the value. And in last, when case 2 program completed, inverted program triangle is completed, then it break the program. If you are not writing this one, then automatically it goes through, fall through is there. We all know what is fall through. It already continuously go to the case 3 or default, whatever is there. So case 2 is completed. So when case 2 is completed, so suppose user gives any other choice, like except 1 and 2. Maybe by mistake or any reason, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10 is a choice. So just because of giving any other choice except 1 and 2, in last there is a, you all have need to write these things. In last, there is a default case. Clear? Default. Like case in the beginning of the program, what we see, there is a case 1 and then whatever we want to print, we just write here. And in last, after writing all the things whatever we want to write in case 1, in last, after completing all these things, in last there is a break. Clear? And then it start case 2 and whatever is there, in last there is a break. In the same way, there is a default statement is also there, and in default statement we have need to write SOP LN and wrong choice. Clear? Whatever user gives, like 3, 4, 5, 6, as so on. If user print or write here in CH except any value 1 or 2, like accept and one and two user write input of 5, 6, 7, 10, 12, 15, 20, whatever number is there, if user gives as an input, that those types of numbers, then it automatically print wrong choice. And when wrong choice is there, then our program is totally completed. We all have need to understand one more thing. 1, 2, 3. 3 curly brackets are open there. So in last, we all have need to close these 3 curly brackets. So opening and closing of curly bracket is very important. And also you all have need to understand the concept of case 1, case 2 and default case. I thought you all understood all these things. And now if you all have any doubt, then you can ask me right now through a WhatsApp message or any other things. So okay, thank you.